I now give the floor to the delegate of Nepal, and I invite the delegate of Costa Rica to come to the rostrum.
Namaskar. Nepal condemns the recent attack of terrorism at a concert in Manchester, and while extending our sympathies and condolences to the victims and their families, we express our solidarity with the government of the United Kingdom. Respected President, Excellencies, Director General Dr. Chan, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take this opportunity to recognize Director General Dr. Chan's 10 years of distinguished service and her contribution in improving global health. We are especially grateful to Dr. Chan and WHO Regional Office, Head Office, for the support Nepal received in the aftermath of the devastating earthquake of 2015. I also take this opportunity to welcome and congratulate Dr. Tedros as the new Director General. I'm confident that the vision Dr. Tedros carries for the WHO will greatly benefit the humanity. I wish him all the success for his tenure. Respected President, confronted with the emergence and re-emergence of many diseases and health challenges in our time, we have taken meaningful initiatives in international health partnerships and charting the course of global health diplomacy. No longer is health an issue of a single nation state. No longer is health confined to delivering healthcare only. If harnessed effectively through partnerships, positive health outcomes can foster economic progress and promote peace and stability. However, respected President, things are yet to move beyond rhetoric. The international cooperation, must be dominated by donor-recipient relations, has not been a true partnership of member states to face common challenges. We have been talking about South-South cooperation, but still not able to harness its true potential. Despite many past discourses on multi-sector action and health in all policies, we have not been effective to inculcate the importance of health into the core business of other sectors. Respected President, WHO will have to play a crucial role to address these practical gaps. While recognizing that ministries of health remain key partners for WHO, it needs to go beyond its customary role of facilitating health agenda through regional offices among ministries of health and start constructive engagement to muster political will through forums like ASEAN, SAARC or African Union. At national level, WHO can play a catalytic role to instill the idea among the political leaderships like finance ministers, foreign ministers, ministers of internal affairs, etc., that resources incurred on health are investments, not expenses, and that health ministries are not the sole custodian of the health sector. Respected President, in Nepal, 67% of out-of-the-pocket spending on health is for drugs and medical commodities. I believe many other countries also confront similar high costs on drugs and medical commodities. This problem keeps straining our health systems and remains a major hindrance in our path towards universal health coverage. However, we have not done much to alleviate the cost of drugs. For developing countries, the disparity between the rich and the poor to cope with the burden of non-communicable diseases is now breeding new forms of health inequities. It is therefore obligatory for us to strengthen primary health care by striking a right balance between investing in community-based approaches and facility-based care, and ensuring linkages between communities and health institutions. Respected President, for countries like ours, meeting the health-related goals and targets of Agenda 2030 for sustainable development means fulfilling the pledge of leaving no one behind. Together, we must break down the barriers that prevent millions around the world to have equitable access to quality health care. For this, we must challenge our conventional thinking and customary ways of doing business. We must explore new avenues of partnerships. We must also walk the talk. Respected President, this is where I believe the new leadership of the WHO will have a crucial role to play. Respected President, in the same manner that we started to mainstream generally in 1990, the dividends of which we are reaping now, it is high time for the movement to mainstream health in global development agenda to tackle poverty and promote freedom and democracy. To conclude, let me quote the words of Henri Frédéric Amiel, a 19th century Swiss philosopher and a native of this city. In health, there is freedom. Health is first of all liberties. Thank you very much. Namaste.
Thank you very much.